Hello and welcome, I'm Flavia and I appreciate you watching this video. Today we are going to create butterfly shaped cards. These are very easy to make and perfect for many different occasions. Before we begin, let me show you the two die sets that I will be using to create these cards. These two sets are from a recent Spellbinders collection release by BB Cameron. This one is the So Many Butterflies set, with lots of die plates to cut out butterflies in many different sizes. I will use the largest butterfly shape in this set to create my card base. This other set is called the Pop-Up Butterfly, and I will use the intricate butterfly set of wings from this die set. So let's begin by creating a butterfly-shaped note card. I will be using this beautiful mint cardstock by Recollections. Off camera, I created a 5x7 inches note card. And what I am doing here is placing the die plate on top of this 5x7 note card in a way where the die is a little bit offset on the left side, which is the side where I created a score line and folded. I will use two pieces of tape to hold my die plate in place as I run this through my die cut machine. I will give you a closer look now so you have a better idea of how much I offset this metal plate. So now that I have my plate secured, securely taped to my 5x7 note card, I will run this through my die cut machine, and just like that, we have created a butterfly shaped note card. I also die cut two butterflies using that same die out of white cardstock this time, so I can adhere them to the inside of this note card. But before I do that, I need to trim some of these white die cut butterflies off so it fits better inside this note card that we just created. To make sure I trim off just the right amount, I will line up a white die cut with the mint butterfly note card. Then, with a pair of scissors, I will cut off the white cardstock that is sticking out. Here is a closer look so you can see that it won't be a lot. It will be just enough to keep these white panels from going over the score line inside the note card. As we do this, keep in mind that we need to create a pair of mirror die cuts, because we are going to adhere one die cut on the right and the other die cut on the left side of this note card. So, with one white die cut butterfly, I will have the right side facing or touching the mint panel as I line them up, and for the second panel, I will have the wrong side, and by that I mean the side of this white die cut that is not smooth, facing or touching the mint butterfly note card as I line them up. That is why I am trimming one butterfly panel at a time. We need to trim one butterfly die cut on the right side and the other one on the left side to create a pair of mirror die cuts, just like this. I am adding these two white panels inside this note card for two reasons. One reason is that this beautiful mint cardstock is not heavyweight. So, by adding these two white panels inside, it will make this note card very sturdy so the recipient can keep it on display. I will show you later how this card will stand up nicely. The other reason is because I prefer writing my message on white cardstock. This is definitely an extra step and you don't have to do this, especially if you are already using heavyweight cardstock for the note card. However, if you do choose to add these two white panels inside, notice that because I trimmed the white panels off a little bit, they do not go over the fold line inside. That is very important because it would have been very difficult to keep this card closed if we had adhered the white panels without trimming them first and letting it go over the score line. So moving on, here is another step that is also optional, but I think it makes all the difference. Because I offset the die plate to create this note card, notice that the left side of this butterfly is not as round as the right side. To fix that, I will adhere another die cut butterfly on top of it. I will score this butterfly die cut in half first, and I will only add liquid adhesive in the back following that score line. So, we could just stop here and start decorating this butterfly. But I will go one step further and die cut another butterfly out of clear acetate this time. Because this is a pretty thick piece of acetate, I will run it through my die cut machine a couple of times. Then, I will use a sanding block to try to smooth the edges and a piece of paper towel with alcohol to clean up this die cut acetate and remove all of my fingerprints. As I mentioned, mentioned at the beginning of this video, I will also be using the intricate set of butterfly wings from the pop-up butterfly set. To make it easier, I will tape together the more intricate die plate with the plate that will cut out the more solid shape. I'm using a mirror gold cardstock, also by Recollections, and you can find a list of all products that I'm using in this video over my blog if you're interested. The next step is to die cut the butterfly body. I used the largest die plate and I cut it 3 times out of that mint cardstock and once out of a gold glitter cardstock. I will stack all of these die cuts for dimension and top it with the glitter cardstock die cut. Once that's done, I will adhere this butterfly body to the golden set of wings. Because this set of wings is meant to be used with a pop-up mechanism, each wing has this large rectangular section in the center. I will trim that off because I don't need it, and adhere the 2 wings together using a piece of double-sided adhesive tape. I could have used liquid adhesive, but I just didn't feel like waiting for the glue to dry. Now I can go ahead and adhere this set of golden wings to the acetate die-cut butterfly. I'm applying liquid adhesive to the back of this die-cut and using my fingertip to spread out the liquid adhesive so I don't have any glue oozing out on my piece of acetate. So now, to adhere this piece of die-cut acetate to my note card, I will use a thin strip of foam adhesive this time, so it has some dimension. Once that's done, the next step is to start decorating this butterfly with some die-cut flowers that I already had ready to go. To die cut these flowers, leaves and sprigs, I used many different die sets also from Spellbinders, and I like to keep them kind of sorted out on these plastic manicotti pasta trays. I'm using the Barely Arts glue to adhere these die cuts to my butterfly. I will also go over them with my Spectrum Noir shimmer pen to add some sparkle. I will now let the music play as you watch me decorating this butterfly shaped note card. So now that I have finished adding all of these flowers and leaves, I will start working on the sentiment for this note card. Using a Happy Birthday die cut by Creative Expressions, I will die cut this sentiment out of black cardstock multiple times so I can stack them up for dimension, and top it with a die cut from black glitter cardstock. This black glitter cardstock has a lot of shining person and it is very beautiful. To finish it off, I will add some gold flat back beads to the center of these flowers. I think that this card is beautiful as it is, and I actually thought that I was done here, but at the last minute, I decided to add a smaller butterfly on the top left corner using a butterfly die plate from this Butterfly Bliss Garden Shutters set, also from Spellbinders. I will add a thin strip of double-sided adhesive only to the center of this butterfly die cut, so I can lift her wings once I'm done. I ended up creating another card just like this one, since I like this design so much, and I will show you in a minute. Before I show you the completed cards, I want to also add a sentiment to the envelope. I'm using a sentiment from this Angel Policy stamp set by Honeybee Stamps. I love this one that says, "Consider this a paper hug." I used it a lot and I thought I would stamp it on the flap of the envelope using a black pigment ink. So here is a closer look on the completed cards. Notice how shiny these die-cut flowers are thanks to that Spectrum Noir shimmer pen. I love how these cards turned out. I would definitely make some more of these butterfly-shaped cards for Mother's Day. I think it will be perfect. So that is all that I have for today, and I hope you enjoyed this video and felt inspired. Remember, you can find more information and pictures of these cards over on my blog, and I will have the link in the description down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel so you do not miss the next one. I hope you have a wonderful day, and see you next time.